I would be just as likely to drink that Diet Coke that may have been there for days than a fresh, cold Diet Coke. Diet Coke is disgusting whether it's been sitting in a garage for days or not. What up? It's the Trooper. It is the day of the millionaire maker, my day one B. It's Saturday, and we're doing things a little bit differently today. First of all, already got the coffee, you saw that. Second of all, dinner break, snacks, breaks, got it covered. Check out what we got. Beef jerky, Reese's Cups, coconut Danish from 85 degrees. Roast beef sandwich made at home. Just roast beef and pepper jack, both sliced very thin on a Dave's Killer Bread hamburger bun. Mustard. Don't want the bread to get soggy over the next few hours. Already had a ham and cheese from 85 degrees, that rhymes, from home. And back full circle to the most important meal of the day. Coffee action, straw action, extra ice action. Oh, we mean business today. We mean business today. Think I wouldn't mean business? What? When the troops jump in and pitch in and we go to war together? Psh, never meant more business in my whole daggone life. It's like 9:45 in the damn morning and I'm here early. I'm here for the first hand. I would never purposely miss the first hand. I mean, sometimes in life shit happens, but today, so far, ain't no shit happened. Knock on some damn wood. This place is made out of concrete. Ain't got no wood in sight. Well, you knock on some fake ass wood somewhere. First break. First 2 hours, not so smooth for us. You start with 25,000 chips in the tournament. At the end of the second level, the second hour, here on the first break, I have exactly half of the starting stack, 12,500. Oh goodness, I had a big hand with kings. And it's a long story, but on the river, the guy bet. There was a 10 jack queen ace on the board, and the guy made a bet, but the river card brought a third heart. The dude led the flop and the turn. I called both times, and the river, he led for 1,200 chips. I raised to 6,200. The dude thought about it for half the level. half the level. So I'm like, he's not thinking about a raise. He's just trying to decide if he wants to call with his king for the chop. Well, that wasn't the case. He had a 9-high flush, and it took him a year to call. What are you gonna do? So, we never say die, we never quit, we never give up. So we're gonna go back in and do the best we can do here with what we have. Blinds are only gonna be 200, 300 with a 300 ante. So, let's go back. Well, that was not my tournament. I am sad to say. It's 221. In the last few minutes of level 4, it folds to the cutoff, who is a bit of a, I don't know if I should call him a maniac. I think he was just a gambler. He had a decent stack. Big blind is 400 with the 400 ante. I'm in the small blind for 200. The cutoff guy makes it 1200. The button folds. I have ace king and 7,500 chips. So I move all in, and the big blind folds, and the guy who raised thought about it for a while, like he had a real decision to make. Should I call this? Wonder what he has. Wonder how my hand will do against whatever we think he might have. He thinks for a while as if he's thinking all that. And finally, he makes the call with 6-4 of clubs. Comes out 6-4. End of the tournament for us. The biggest problems for me today were pocket kings before the flop, ace king before the flop, and queen jack of hearts. I flopped bottom two pair on a king queen jack, first to act on the flop, two players behind me. Long story short, 6-4 guy had ace nine in his hand, managed to call the flop somehow, and the 10 hit the river. So there's nothing worse than busting out of a tournament when the troops are involved. I want to say that sometimes it's just not your day, but I'm not really sure I want to, what do you want? It's a damn bird. I'm not sure I want to count out the entire day yet. It's only 2:23 in the PM. Tomorrow is Sunday and there's nothing specific on the agenda. I am thinking about playing this tournament on Monday though. The $500 situation, whatever it is. What the hell is it? Monday, it's a $500, it's just a $500 no limit hold'em tournament. Probably a bit of a turbo. I'm probably gonna go back in and play some single table satellites. What a letdown. Today was just a disaster. From the very first card dealt, it was a disaster. I must have flopped early in the game when we were like six-handed. I must have flopped like four open-enders. And you know, it's like 300, guy calls 300, of course I call 300, whatever, da-da-da-da-da. You know, just little pots or whatever, and then I had the kings, which basically chopped me down to half the starting stack. I'm not gonna stand here and ramble on and on about it. I mean, if we're gonna bust out of the tournament and not get in the money, then we might as well bust out in level 4. I think that bird's trying to shit on me. Let's get out of here. I just realized I made a rookie mistake today. I didn't bring any money with me because I had planned to be playing the Millionaire Maker all day. That's a rookie mistake. I do have two lammers in my pocket though. So two lammers and like 150 bucks. I do have one 175 ticket in the backpack too. So I could go play the, I think I'm gonna go play one 175 and then see what happens. I thought about the lammers. I'm like, well, maybe I can just buy a bunch of tickets or whatever, but you gotta have this, the odd cash And not only that, I won't have any money for last longers. Let's go play the one, because I will have money for last longer on that one. Well, the one single table satellite didn't go well. There were 8 players remaining at 75-150. Folds to me on the button. I have 950, ace queen, put it in, small blind wakes up with kings. Things are not going very smoothly. So tomorrow is Sunday. I'm gonna come back fresh tomorrow, play single tables all day, and I think we should play, so I decided I want to play the $500 tournament on Monday. And I was thinking I'm going to play it on my own. But I think I'm not going to play it on my own just because I want you guys to be included in it if you want to be. So it's, I think it's probably like twice as fast as the tournament that I played today. You start with 25,000 chips the same, but the levels are 30 minutes long as opposed to 1 hour long. So I don't know what you guys would want me to do, right? Should we do, are people okay with playing $25 or $50 in a tournament? Because I feel inclined to sell 50% of the tournament, but put like a $25 limit on it so that 10 people can play. I think that's what I'm gonna do. As soon as this video goes live on Sunday, the $500 no limit hold'em freeze out on Monday. Let me double check the thing. Event number 43, freeze out, no limit hold'em, $500. It's a 2-day tournament, so it will end on Tuesday. So tomorrow, Sunday, I'm gonna play single table satellites. By the time you see this video, this tournament will be live. I'm gonna put this tournament on Stake Kings just before I release this video. And then I'm gonna put a $25 limit on it. So anybody who wants to play to have a sweat, can get a piece of it up to 25 bucks. I mean, is that a good idea? I mean, if you don't put a limit, one person's just gonna buy the whole 250. And I mean, I don't really have a problem with that, except for the fact that I would want more people to have a little shot at something, you know what I mean? I also may try something else. I was thinking about it today. I was thinking that I should live blog the tournament on Go Gamble World. So live updates whenever big hands happen, chip stack updates and stuff like that, right on Go Gamble World. Start like a post and then update the post as the day goes on. I'm gonna have to look into that. We'll figure something out, but yo, let's play the $500 tournament. Good luck getting in. Don't forget, we're gonna do the main event, and I'm gonna look at the schedule and try to get an idea of what the next bigger tournament will be. But in the meantime, remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos, leave a comment down below. Do you like this t-shirt? I like it. Personally, I like it. I'll see you next time.